Welcome to Ice Fishing Country, home of the famous auto step-jig. My name is Rudy. I love ice fishing and the outdoors, and would like to share that with you through a series of videos. Building a DIY do-it-yourself ice fishing shack or ice shanty is exciting. The objective, of course, is to have some place where you and your friends can go for a warm, relaxing ice fishing experience. But before you decide to proceed with your project, I recommend you watch this video, which illustrates some of the challenges of owning an ice fishing shack. The first step is sketching your floor plan with your budget in mind. Then you need some place to build your project and plan for moving it to your fishing honey hole location. Assuming you have a truck and trailer, a winch on the trailer gets the shack on and off, or your shack design may include running gear. In the early season, before the ice is thick enough for truck traffic, perhaps you or your friend has an ATV to tow the shack to your desired location. If your fishing shack has a small footprint, you'll want to anchor it. I have seen ice shacks tipped over and destroyed by high wind conditions. This shack has four corner pipe extensions that are purposely watered and frozen into the ice. Note the ice ridge in the background. This usually means that there will be water on top of the ice. Put your shack runners on blocks of wood so that they do not freeze solidly into the ice. Many anglers like to fish next to an ice ridge. They believe the open water and ice ridge channels the walleye along the ridge. Open lake conditions, wind and blowing snow. Sometimes you may have to move your shack out of a high surrounding snowbank. These little critters like fish too. Some inconsiderate anglers leave bait fish and food scraps outside their ice shack, which attracts wildlife. I've heard stories that a mink or marten really messed up an ice shack that didn't have their floor fishing holes covered adequately. Regulations require shack contact information to be clearly displayed. This is a good thing, so that your ice fishing neighbors or others can contact you to report a potential problem with your shack. There is nothing like the feeling of comfort and enjoyment of your own ice shack. But we do have some pretty convenient ice shelter options. In the next video, I will illustrate some of these ice fishing shelter options. I would be happy to hear from you with your comments and questions.